بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
اللہ کے نام سے جو رحمان اور رحیم ہے.
To make this great state of Pakistan happy and prosperous, we must concentrate wholly and solely on the well-being of the people.
Pakistan, the gateway to Central Asia, enjoys a marvelous location on the map of the world. Confined to natural boundaries to the south and the north, this piece of land is abundant with topographical and geographical beauty. It reflects all colors of life. All four seasons throughout the year add charm to the beauty and magnificence of this land that make life diversified and innovative. History of the land dates back to centuries BC, when we trace the hoofs of horses of Alexander the Great. This part of the earth has been a cradle of the world's most ancient civilizations and cultures. People of Pakistan are industrious and hardworking. Cultured with the lifestyles of people of four provinces add to the richness and beauty of life. Agriculture and industry are the mainstay of economy. Whereas mainstay of agriculture and industry is the Indus River, along with its tributary rivers and the dams constructed on these water reservoirs. Located at a distance of 40 air miles, 64 kilometers to the northwest of Islamabad, the Indus, locally known as the Abbasin, meaning the father of rivers. Tarbela Dam is one of the world's largest water resources development project. The project is the capstone of the Indus Basin Plan to ensure a continued and improved supply of water to the millions of acres of irrigated land in Pakistan, besides generating hydroelectricity and controlling floods. The Tarbela Dam is the world's largest earth-filled dam that depicts the ultimate grandeur and spirit infused with will and determination. Due to its eternal richness and resourcefulness, the Indus River has been a dynamic force causing revolutionary advancements in the lifestyles of those who have been abiding around the Indus River. Emerging from the land of glaciers, on the northern slopes of Kailash Ranges, the River Indus has its origins in the Himalayan catchment area. The catchment area of Indus at Tarbela is 169,600 square kilometers, which is unique in the sense that it contains 7 of the world's 10 highest peaks. Also barring the polar area, 7 glaciers situated in the Indus catchment rank amongst the largest in the world. The Indus flows 2,900 kilometers, draining an area of about 963,480 square kilometers before it falls out into the Arabian Sea. The actual cultivated area is about 39 million acres, of which nearly 33 million acres, almost 85%, depends upon a vast canal irrigation system tributaries. Today, the system consists of about 61,000 kilometers of canals and a series of river barrages and canal headworks.
The Tarbela project was started at that time. The civil contracts equal to about $623 million was the biggest civil engineering contract ever awarded in the history of dam project. The country which won this project in the civil engineering was from Italy by the name of Imperigillo.
I feel, first of all, overwhelmed by the imposing size and the beauty of this work, which is definitely something that we are very proud of, both as ambassador and as a country. And I would say that your gratitude is very welcome, but in fact it was a very economical project which was carried out by an Italian firm back in the early 70s. The thing that is most relevant in this endeavor is the fact that it was the first big dam project in Pakistan that we can claim that this dam was in fact like the establishment of a backbone for the developing industry, for the developing capacities of the country. We believe, or I think we rightly believe, that this dam represented a major step in the development of Pakistan. I am very proud that well, Italians contributed so much.
The construction was carried out in three stages. In first stage, allowing the river to flow with its natural channel work was initiated on right bank, where 13,000 feet long, 694 feet wide, and 60 feet depth diversion channel was excavated, and a 105 feet high concrete buttress dam was constructed. The diversion channel had a capacity to discharge 750,000 cusecs. This phase lasted 2.5 years. In stage two, that lasted for 3 years, the main embankment dam and the upstream blanket were constructed across the main valley. Then, tunnels were built for diversion purposes. Under stage three, the river was made to flow through tunnels. The remaining portion of upstream blanket and the main dam at higher level were also completed. This spillway construction was also carried out as a part of stage 3 from October 1970 to August 1974 during the stages 2 and 3 period. The principal element of the project is an embankment dam 9,000 feet long with a height of 470 feet. The total volume of earth and rock for the project is approximately 200 million cubic yards, which made it the largest earth-filled man-made structure in the world in 1974. The project has proved to be a masterpiece of civil engineering. The project has been designed with crisis management measures and remedial actions. Annually, Tarbela Reservoir releases about 9 million acre-feet of water for irrigation, depending upon the requirement of irrigation agriculture. A total of 247 million acre-feet of water has been released up to 30th June 2004, which in monetary terms would roughly mean an input to the national economy worth ₹101 billion, adding to it about ₹84 billion being the value of hydroelectricity generated at Tarbela Powerhouse up to 30th June 2004. The total benefits in financial terms have already exceeded the cost of the project after first 10 years of its operation. At peak of construction activities, over 15,000 Pakistani and 800 European workers, including engineers and technicians of the contractors organization, were working at the project site. WAPDA staff was composed of some 1,400 personnel. The Tarbela contract was the largest unit price construction contract ever awarded. The four tunnels, low-level outlets, each about half a mile long through the right abutment, are serving as water diversion channels, besides being power-generating sources. Two spillways at a peak discharge carry an energy of about 40 million horsepower. Water velocities at the spillway chutes are in the region of 150 feet per second, 46 meters per second. Expected life is 83 years on an 80% silt-up basis, 2057 based on the present rate. Although the project was designed and constructed to serve the irrigation purposes, but the following studies revealed huge potentials for hydropower generations as well. According to the original plan, four power units of 175 megawatts generation capacity each were to be installed on each of the tunnels 1, 2 and 3 with the ultimate installed capacity of 2,100 megawatts. But the later developments have increased this capacity to 3,478 megawatts. Tarbela Dam is not only a masterpiece of civil engineering, but it also has multifaceted, vital and dynamic openings and many vistas simultaneously. The project has opened vistas of job opportunities as an employer, accommodating thousands of workers. It has been owing a sizable contribution to fight against poverty with a practical uplift of millions of people. If we take this project as a role model, one can imagine easily the progress graph of Pakistan with more dams. Tarbela Dam has really proved to be a national asset, and Pakistan Army is very much aware of its obligations to provide reliable safeguards for this national asset.
Say, I'm not, no, she.
Concentrate wholly and solely